Assalamu alaikum, my name is Tahir Hussain and today we are going to discuss some parameters of cooling tower. In this video, we'll be explaining about basic concepts of cooling tower, range of cooling tower, approach of cooling tower and efficiency of the cooling tower. A cooling tower is known as a wet bulb device and works on the principle of evaporation. Cooling towers are a very important part of many process plants and power plants. The backup water source is used to refill water lost due to evaporation. Hot water from heat exchanger condenser is sent to the cooling tower. After reducing the temperature of water in cooling tower, it is sent back by a circulation pump again to the condenser or heat exchanger. The performance of cooling tower is estimated by approach and range. During the performance assessment, portable monitoring instruments are used to measure the following parameters: dry bulb temperature of air, wet bulb temperature of air, cooling tower inlet water temperature. This is the cooling water inlet water temperature, cooling tower outlet temperature. This is the outlet temperature, electrical reading of pump and fan, exhaust air temperature, water flow rate and air flow rate. First, we will see what is the range. The range is the difference between the cooling, if you will go to the last slides, the range is the difference between the hot water inlet and cold water outlet. This is the difference of temperature is called the range. So range of cooling tower is cooling tower inlet temperature and cooling tower outlet temperature. We will see one example. For example, if the cooling tower inlet temperature is 38 degree centigrade and cooling tower outlet temperature is 30 degree centigrade, so difference will be 8 degree centigrade. So this 8 degree centigrade is the range of the cooling tower. So range represents is cooling tower properly cool water or not. If range is increased, if outlet temperature will be 28, if range is increased mean, for example, if we will see here the outlet temperature is 30, if we will take the outlet temperature is 28, range will be now 10. It means cooling tower performance is good. If range is decreased, it shows cooling tower is not working properly. Now we will see what is approach. The difference between the cooling tower outlet temperature and ambient wet bulb temperature of entering air is called the approach of a cooling tower. If we will go to the last slides. The difference of between, this is the cold water is outlet is going out from the cooling tower and this is the wet bulb air temperature that is entering, the air is entering to the cooling tower through a louvers. The difference, the temperature of this and this one air is called the approach. So we will see one example. For example, if the cooling water outlet temperature is 30 degree centigrade and air entering wet bulb temperature is 26 degree centigrade, the difference now will come 4 degree centigrade. So this is the approach of the cooling tower. Approach represents the cooling tower performance. That is why approach is called best performance of cooling tower. Now we will see an important factor is the weather. Weather plays an important role as humidity of the environment directly affects the cooling efficiency of cooling tower. Short answer, cooling tower performance mainly depends on wet bulb temperature. As a general rule, the higher the wet bulb temperature above the design condition, the lower the cooling tower capacity. The wet bulb temperature is nothing but relative humidity. Wet bulb temperature essentially measures how much water vapor the atmosphere can hold at current weather conditions. So in layman, if we want to explain to the layman, so layman terms that lower wet bulb temperature means the air is drier and can hold more water vapor than it can a higher wet bulb temperature. For example, if the wet bulb temperature is 32 degrees centigrade, that means the relative humidity is very high. When the relative humidity is high, not much evaporation will take place. That means the cooling tower is not transferring much heat to the environment. So if you are operating in a high, if you have the condition, for example, if the humidity is very high, so how to operate the cooling tower? So if you are operating in a high humidity weather, you can improve the amount of heat being transferred to the environment is to increase the temperature difference between the cooling tower temperature and the environment temperature. So all you can do in a high humidity environment to improve the amount of heat transferred by a cooling tower is to increase the temperature of water going into the cooling tower. Increase the airflow will not yield much of an improvement in efficiency. A typical tower for comfort air conditioning application AHIR standard condition would be, we will see how the AHI is saying, would see 35 degree water entering the tower and leaving at 30 degrees centigrade. This is an outdoor ambient temperature is 35 and a wet bulb temperature is 25.6. Now we are going to discuss one case. If the water entering to the cooling tower is 35 degrees centigrade and leaving is 30 degrees centigrade and the ambient temperature of air outside is 35 degrees centigrade and wet bulb temperature is 25.6 degrees centigrade. If the wet bulb temperature is lower, mean if we will decrease the wet bulb temperature up to 23.3, the tower can cool more water. If it is higher, the capacity will be less. And if we will increase the wet bulb temperature, the capacity of cooling tower will be less. But if the outside air temperature is say 38, before was 35, now 38 degrees centigrade, but has a wet bulb temperature is 15.6, I mean less temperature as we discussed before 25.6, now we are saying 15.6 wet bulb temperature and the water is entering at 29.4, should be centigrade, not Fahrenheit, this by mistake. The ambient dry bulb temperature, the 38 degrees centigrade will add some heat to the water. But the much drier, because the air is much drier, why it is dry? Because wet bulb temperature is very lower, meaning the 15.6 wet bulb temperature will more than compensate for that. Actually, we are discussing here, if the air ambient temperature, even it is high 38 degrees centigrade, because the wet bulb temperature is low, so it can be compensated of this heat what is transferring to the water through the atmosphere. Commonly, the closer the approach to the wet bulb, the more expensive is the cooling tower due to increased size. Usually, a 2.8 degree centigrade approach to the wet bulb is the coldest water temperature that manufacturer will guarantee. Now we see how to calculate the efficiency of a cooling tower. The efficiency of the cooling tower is the formula range divided by range plus approach. So we are calculating the percentage, that is we are multiplying the 100. In practice, the cooling tower efficiency will be between 65% to 70%. In summer season, the ambient air wet bulb temperature rises when compared to winter season. So cooling tower efficiency limiting in summer season. In this calculation, cooling tower approach and cooling tower range are important factors. Cooling tower performance varies season to season. In Pakistan, for example, we'll take the example of Pakistan. We have three weather seasons, winter, summer, and rainy. The performance of cooling tower will be different in these three weather. The efficiency of cooling tower will be best in winter season, secondly in summer, and then in rainy season. Cooling tower performance is depending on the relative humidity. And in rainy season, relative humidity is high, more moisture available in air. That is why the efficiency of the cooling tower will be less. So how to calculate the range and approach we already discussed. We will calculate, if we will calculate this parameter and put here, we can calculate the efficiency of a cooling tower. I hope you will like this video. Thank you very much.